Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the Geek Planet. I'm Jeff.
And I'm Jason.
And today we're going to review Shazam! Yeah, Shazam.
Shazam!
Yeah, Shazam.
They probably think that we're doing something Game of Thrones related here.
Possibly, because we do have our lovely
array here of alcoholic beverages, adult beverages, Game of Thrones themed, the Johnny Walker White Walker, yes, and the Almond Gang. This isn't
pay promotion. This isn't
This isn't pay promotion.
That would be nice, though.
Yeah, it would just be amazing. We're just huge fans of the show. I work for a distributor. We do distribute for Almond Gang. They do amazing beers. I've been following this line since they've actually started it. It's great. And we're just super excited about Game of Thrones season starting, what's next Sunday, right?
Yeah, a week from tomorrow.
A week from tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah. We'll actually be in Chicago for Celebration during
that. Well, yes, yes. So we're like cross-promoting the hell out of everything here, aren't we?
Pretty much, yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
Yes, we just got back from Shazam.
Yeah, we did. We went with me, my wife, him and his wife, and another friend and his girlfriend, and they're all downstairs playing drinking games actually right now, and we're reviewing this and having some drinks, but
we're up here with you guys.
We're talking Shazam, because we just got out of this movie. We went to one of our local theaters that serves food with it and alcohol, so had a good time, but
What did you think of that?
The Royal Suite in Evansville?
Yeah, the Royal Suite. What did you think about it?
I actually liked it. That was my first time doing it. We live in Evansville, Indiana, by the way, and we go to Showplace Cinemas. Me and him usually go to IMAX. That's just our thing.
It's the only way to see movies. Yeah, so I feel. If you can see it in IMAX 3D, it's always worth the money.
Yeah,
I have no problem paying an extra $6-7 whatever they charge. No. I always upgrade to IMAX. It's the only way I feel fit to see a movie anymore.
I will say that the screen quality in the Royal Suite, the digital screen they had, was really good. It was much bigger than a normal screen.
Yeah.
And had the Dolby Atmos lined in the ceiling, and it sounded really good.
The sound is amazing in there.
Just fantastic. It was just really good representation of a movie when you watch it like that. Mm-hmm. So hopefully they will redo their IMAX theater to make it more like that eventually. But so we walked out of this. The credits start to roll, of course, and you know, we kind of do our thought process when it's over. Did you like it?
I did. Going into this movie, as we previously discussed, I really was always, how I always like to do it, blank slate. Mm-hmm. I don't want to go in there with a yay or nay.
Yeah.
I don't like other people persuading me. Granted, I drive for my job, and I was listening to a radio broadcast, and so happened to hear a local radio station doing a movie review on this movie. I won't mention names or what station or anything like that, obviously. But after listening to it, it really kind of almost put in the back of my head that I'm going into more of a childish, kiddie kind of kids movie. And not to like stray you away from that, I mean, it really is. I mean, obviously there are children in this movie, but it is a child-based movie, I mean, with adult themes, adult language. There's, from what this person was saying about this movie, I didn't see really any of it, other than the fact that there might have been some heartfelt moments in the movie that kind of, it kind of made you kind of relate a little to these, or try to relate to these children. No, I mean, it had the perfect amount of balance of comedy and action and enough storyline to keep me going, because I've never been a big follower of a lot of DC comics other than Batman and Superman. So I did not know really much about Shazam other than what maybe I had looked into. So yeah, at the very end of the movie, that's why, you know, you and I, when we had our discussion, I had no freaking clue what the hell was going on. But it still kind of drew me in at the end, and I was like, oh, we're gonna get a sequel. Yes. And I really, before going into the movie, I could have cared less if they would have made a sequel, just in the back of my mind. But now I'm excited. I want more. I think it was an all around great flick. Aside from a little bit of the language, you know, dropping a couple S bombs, which, I mean, nowadays they let fly on the air, on cable now.
They do. Worse on cable.
You know, I wouldn't even say that. I wouldn't even hesitate to say that this would be a great movie for your kids too. I mean, honestly, I'm sure kids hear worse things throughout their day in school. So, I really thoroughly enjoyed this movie. I laughed. I mean, there was a couple scenes where I laughed out loud, maybe at the wrong things. But it was good. It was really good. How about you?
I really liked it too. Going into it, so I have been more of a follower of DC. I'm going from the DC end to Marvel end, I'm more of a DC Comics guy, but then Marvel, I'm like, it's Spider-Man is one of my top, even top comics. So Spider-Man's always on top for most of my comics, but Batman, Superman, and a couple other random stuff like Spawn. But I read the new 52 run of Shazam. I actually went online and read some of the old stuff like in the last few months. Really cool stuff in there too. So it kind of, a little few things fit. I went in, I like Zachary Levi. I thought he was going to bring really good, you know, chemistry to it with playing the adult version of Shazam.
Right.
But yeah, I went into it kind of with just a blank slate because I didn't want to have a bias going into it because I'm a DC fan. Even though I love MCU, I love Marvel movies, and I really do like a lot of the Infinity stories from the comics. A lot of X-Men stuff too. I went in kind of just blank slate, and I came out really enjoying it. It made me laugh a lot in a couple spots I shouldn't have laughed at, just like him. Mm-hmm. And then it was a really good heartfelt story too about family, and it kind of helps you relate with the characters, which is a good part of the story. Makes you feel for those characters.
It really does.
You know?
Yeah, it really does.
And the kid that played Freddy that's in it, every scene he's in, he steals it. Like, it's just...
He crushed
him. Him and Zachary Levi's, their chemistry is just... makes the movie work. If they had cast somebody else in those roles,
yeah,
it would not have worked. And when Billy is 14, his normal age, the kid that plays him, I can't remember any of their names right now, so I'll put him on the screen. He's awesome too. They all worked really well, and all the foster kids in the home, it just worked really well.
Yeah.
And Mark Strong as the villain did a really good job.
Yeah.
I just really thoroughly enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun, and you were, like you said, it was like the right amount of action, the right amount of comedy, the right amount of drama and heartfelt stuff and story to kind of connect everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really liked it. I really did.
So I like you said, the whole chemistry between, you know, the adult version and the kid, Billy,
yeah,
was something you don't see a lot. I mean, it reminded me of Big with Tom Hanks.
Yeah.
And the little nod to the movie with the giant piano,
yep,
was kind of badass that I thought.
That was great.
I really like that. Wish I was, when I saw it happening, I thought we were actually going to get like an actual, you know, like something to kind of play into that. But it was really just like, oh, the giant piano, it's here, it's, you know, hey.
Yeah, he's normally small, but he's big now.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, it was great. It was fantastic.
I like that a lot. But yeah, the chemistry between those two is phenomenal. You don't see that a lot. Usually one person kind of overshadows, mm-hmm, mainly the child actor always gets overshadowed by the adult actor. Mm-hmm. It's just the way it goes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This kid freaking nailed it.
He
crushed it. So good.
Every scene he was in, he almost like, you kind of felt sorry for him, but he didn't want that pity.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
Because he'd been living with it all his life, and that's what I love most about him. Yeah. Like, he owned his handicap, yeah, and he owned being a foster child, yeah, and he was like, I don't give a... This is who I am, yeah, and I love superheroes. Everything about him just was... I love that character more than anything. I actually think I like the child version of him more than when he actually
turned into,
yeah,
yeah,
when he turned. Yeah. So, but you know, speaking of that, you know, I heard you say at the end of the movie, you know, you were expecting maybe that we were going to see these turn maybe later in at the very end of the movie.
Yeah, that's why.
Were you a little surprised that they did it so soon, or are you happy?
Like, I was glad they did, because at the point in the movie, he kind of needed that distraction so he could go off with Dr. Savano, mm-hmm, on his own. And so I thought that worked out really well. And yeah, I like how, and of course it's like that in the comics where they don't have every power he has. Each one has one of his powers together.
Okay. So one has like, speed, one has...
Yeah,
okay.
Mm-hmm. And
okay,
he has all of them together because he's the main champion that,
right,
was picked.
Right,
but, yeah, I expected them at the end, after they were in it for a little bit, I'm like, yeah, this is probably going to be the Shazam family. Probably going to get that. And then we did, and I thought it came at the right time, and it worked out well. And I liked how he had to save those kids, the bullies, at the end, and he gave them Wedgie while he saved them. That was pretty funny.
That was funny. Yeah, yeah, that part. I mean, I saw that kind of coming. He was going to save them. Mm-hmm. Now giving him the Wedgies was probably, you know, the best part about it.
What about Santa Claus running around?
My God, the Santa Claus in this movie steals it, God, crushes it.
It's hilarious.
It's probably one of the funniest scenes you'll ever see.
Yeah, it's great.
It's a great kind of climactic ending to the whole chaos that is at the end. But yeah, with the whole team kind of forming, and me, like I said, I've never been a big follower of this comic book. I kind of expected Maybe with the seven deadly sins, maybe their powers being transformed into good and being put into those. Because I saw the whole Shazam family coming from the moment when you saw the bus at the very beginning of the movie move and they're all standing in a row on the street.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, there. It set it up from the very get-go. Yeah. I mean, we're 10 minutes, 15 minutes into the
and
movie.
And they're all together.
And as soon as he gets into his foster home, the next day he's off to school.
And they're all together.
Bus moves and they're all lined up on the street. I mean, it basically sets it up perfectly.
It did. I didn't even think about
it. It hit me the moment I saw that. I was like, there's the whole family right there. Because I knew Freddy was going to be one.
Yeah.
Just from the release of all the action figures and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And
that did kind of spoil it. Yeah, I saw Freddy's, but I didn't see the rest of them.
I saw what was the Mexican kid's name, the one that barely talked.
Yeah, I can't remember his name.
But I saw his figure too when I was at Target. Like you said, that it's probably one of the things I hate most about movies nowadays. I mean, I understand these other toy companies have to make their money and do these things. But like they'll put out toys before the movie even hits, we're getting secrets and snip and things like this, kind of brought out into the open before we even get to go see the movie. And then when you watch the movie, you go, "Oh, that makes sense now."
I see why. Yeah, Lego sets do that a lot. Yeah,
it all made sense when I saw those Funko Pops, and because I'm looking at all these different characters on the back, and I'm going, "Who the hell are these people?" Yeah. But the moment that bus moved, I was like,
"Yeah, they are.
There they are.
Yeah,
it's all them right there." So, but it's cool. I think that's the coolest part about it is they're all foster children.
Yeah.
They're all children that have been kind of cast aside,
yeah.
And now they're the ones kind of
coming together.
Yeah, they're coming together to basically save humanity or save the day in a sense. But yeah, man, I definitely have to recommend this movie for.
I agree.
I would say all ages.
My 4-year-old nephew went and saw it, and my mom said he had a few problems with a few scenes, but other than that, he was fine because I didn't expect them to go all out with the seven deadly sins. I really didn't, but then they did.
That was that was might be a little.
They went a little bit all in. Yeah.
It might be a little terrifying. In the scene when the lady touches the door and like her entire body just kind of.
Yeah.
Kind of just turns into ash and she's screaming.
Oh, yeah, when she's screaming
and like that part was a little decrepit.
I was like, dang, they really went for that.
Yeah, that was a little decrepit, but other than that, man, I mean, yeah, the seven deadly sins were scary, but I dig that storyline. You know, that takes me back to the whole Brad Pitt Seven movie, and I've always been a huge fan of that movie.
And it really did a good job with incorporating that because when I heard they were going to do it, I was like, yeah, that's going to be. How are they going to do this?
Yeah.
And then they're like, we're just going all in, screw it.
And they didn't give us any clue to it in the trailers or anything like
that.
No,
they
didn't. Which I love.
They didn't do any of it in the trailers.
I love
that.
Once again, you know, you get to go watch a movie and when
they didn't show the Shazam family. They barely showed Dr. Savano. They barely showed any of him fighting Shazam.
Mm-hmm.
It was mainly like the first half of the movie. You had to see like clips from the trailer. It was like the first half of the movie.
Right, right.
Maybe not the whole thing, but like snippets from it.
Hopefully other movies will take note on this, kind of like what the Avengers are doing right now, where, I mean, I get it. I feel like, yeah, they're not giving us a lot. They don't have to. I mean, they're going to break.
We don't need it.
They're going to crush box office records, and they don't need, all they would have to do is flash the damn logo up and show all those guys walking in those white suits, and basically that's really all they've given us, and we're all going to go.
We're already wearing our tickets.
You know, crazy and buy tickets. But I just wish a lot of other movies would go back to that format where like you give us a little but
not all of it.
Yeah, just
they definitely sold it with the trailers because what they used for the promotional material, especially the scenes where him and Freddy are trying to figure everything out and when they go in the store and they prevent the robbery from happening and they go get beer.
Yeah.
That just sells that movie because you already kind of have an idea what you're getting into and with that aspect I also liked how they kept trying to name him.
He kept
coming up with names.
He never had the name Shazam until the very end of the movie.
Captain
Sparkle
pretty much.
Fingers. I mean, Sparkle Fingers. Mr. What is it? Mr. Fantastic or something
like that. And then
like
Thunderclap or
Thunderclap,
something.
Thunderclap.
I honestly thought for a second when he kept naming him that he was going to say, how about Captain Marvel? And he'd be like, no, I don't like that name. Because how he was originally Captain Marvel and they were going to bring it up but they didn't, which That's fine.
That kind of would have been funny.
I thought that would have been funny if they would have done that. If they would have done that.
No, that would have probably topped it off for me right there. And I liked with the whole villains. He never really name dropped, and you never really heard his name throughout the entire movie, other than at the very beginning when she was doing the conference call with the lady who had the interaction with the Shazam wizard.
Yeah.
That was pretty much. I mean, there's even a scene where they ask, "Who are you? What are you here for?" And he never says his name.
Yep.
Never says his name. Mm-hmm. It's always straight to, you know, what is his whole deal, and that's it.
I like how the beginning with the setup of Dr. Savano's Thad. I guess it was Thaddeus. Thaddeus?
Yeah.
Yeah. Set up that, like, mirror arc for Billy, where he's not worthy, but he is.
Yeah. And
they're both kind of...
at the same age.
In the same age. Billy doesn't have a mom because she basically just freaking left him.
Mm-hmm.
And then his dad hates him.
Yeah.
His brother hates him.
Yeah.
It just kind of... had an opposite effect to it.
Mm-hmm.
I like how they started off with that, and I loved how the dad was the Lionel Luther from Smallville.
Oh, that was
yeah.
Him. Yeah.
He was also in Gremlins, too, by the way. But, I liked how he played that character, and I thought that was a really... I was like, yeah, that works.
Bringing back another
DC show into this. But, yeah. I thought Dr. Mark Strong did a really good job as a villain.
He has a villain-esque look to him anyway, man. He has that, like, square jawline and that that he always he always walks around with. So, like, him being in a villain's role...
like, sold that.
Yeah.
He sold that.
He's just... he has a cold demeanor about him.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah. Literally, he just has this cold demeanor about him that you just... it's not... I don't want to say you just can't do nothing but hate him, but, like, you know he's up to no good no matter what. And, you know, when he's walking around with the glasses on and you can't actually see his eyes, it's just like a dead, stoned, evil presence, no matter... And he's not even doing anything. Like, the scene when he walks into the boardroom, like, you know nothing good is about to happen.
Yeah.
Like, there's nothing good that is going to come out of any of this situation.
Yeah.
And then you find out, you know, not only is his dad there, but his older brother and the whole what happened with the business. Yeah. I mean... that was probably one of my favorite scenes.
That was a great
when
scene.
When you actually realize...
sets up the whole... sets everything up.
Because you actually start to see how he's got his
power.
How he got his power and what his payoff was for actually going back and taking the orb when the wizard told him not to.
When he's not worthy because he failed the test. He failed the test.
But
I knew going in, even though I had a blank slate, I knew it was probably going to be pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't think I would enjoy it as much as I did. And I don't know if you ever watched a show called Chuck that Zachary Levi starred in. It was like his big thing. But I really liked that show, and I thought he was great in that. And when I heard he was cast in this, I was like, that's kind of perfect for that.
Mm-hmm.
He plays that role really well. Just the whole movie, the arc, and the ending with all the family together, and then how, like I said, Mark Strong did a really good job as a villain. I was expecting maybe just a cookie cutter, here's a villain,
mm-hmm.
here's a villain. No, I thought he just kind of really made it his own. Made it to where you kind of felt for his struggle, because the way his dad, brother, treated him in the beginning, you're like, damn, this kid's put up with some stuff.
Yeah.
You know?
No, I mean, you can completely see why he chose what he...
Yes.
The path he actually took.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it made sense. You know, when you're being told you're basically never going to become a man, you're useless, and these seven, you know, demons are basically feeding you... and pumping you full of everything you want to hear to make you choose their side. I mean, obviously, you understand why he did what he did. Mm-hmm. You do kind of develop a little bit of a relationship with that character as well. And then, you know, you see him clash at the end. Granted, you know, it's almost like he wants that power to kind of prove not only to himself, but, you know, what he wanted to try to prove to his dad is like, I'm the man.
Yeah.
I'm the man now. I want all the power. And I don't know. Like you said, you went into it with a blank slate. I did too. I really honestly felt like I was going to leave this movie and be sitting here right now kind of, I wouldn't say bashing this movie, but not liking it nearly as much as I did.
Yeah.
I wouldn't call it like a Thor Ragnarok kind of review that I was going to, you know, but I knew.
Yeah.
I felt like, I felt in the back of my head I was really not going to be very, very entertained, may I say, with this movie. And completely opposite. I highly recommend it. I think everybody should go see it. It's great. It's a good laugh. I would go actually see it again. I would love to go see it in IMAX, to be honest.
Me too. It'll look great. Yeah.
So the 10 rating. What are you gonna go? Where are you gonna go with it?
Ooh, okay. Ooh. I'm gonna go 8. I'm gonna go 8 out of 10.
Eight.
Yeah, I'm gonna go 8.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm.
I'm agreeing.
You're going to go 8?
Yeah, okay. I'm going to say 8.
You're going 8. So on our meter, we're both doing 8. So we'll do 8.
I would definitely give it an 8, mm-hmm. but a big, huge, you know, yeah, high recommendation, yeah, thumbs up, yeah, to go see it. You know, obviously, everybody has their own opinion. That's the great part about them. But,
go out and support this movie. You're going to have fun.
Yeah.
You're really going to have a good time, and you're going to enjoy it. Take your family, take your friends. That's Shazam. We really liked it. We hope you guys did too. What did you think? Leave a comment below.
Yeah, let us know
what you think.
Let us know if when you guys saw it. Did you go the opening night?
Yeah.
You know, I'm kind of interested too. How many people actually were? This was another movie where I felt like, you know, we could have maybe, other than trying to get a review out. So because I mean that's kind of what we want to be mm-hmm. doing for you people is getting a review out as soon as possible. I kind of sat back and thought this could have been a movie that I could have waited a few weeks to see. Mm-hmm. Hell, I could have went to the $2 theater and seen it. Now I'm glad I didn't. So definitely, we'd like to know, like, did you go see it opening night? Were you that excited? You know,
did it pique your interest enough to go see it the first weekend?
Yeah.
Are you waiting for word of mouth to see if you go see it again? But if it's been out for a month and you're watching this video, what'd you think of it after you see it then?
Mm-hmm.
But let us know. But we appreciate you guys stopping by. Next week, we're going to have all kinds of stuff. So be prepared for, like, a content dump. We're going to do our best to get as much out as we can.
Live from Shy.
Yeah, we're going to do some stuff. So we appreciate you guys checking out the video.
Yeah, guys.
And we definitely recommend Shazam. Go see it. Game of Thrones is coming up a week from tomorrow. We're going to try to do something for that. We're going to be in Chicago. We're going to be in a hotel room. So we'll see. If not then, we'll do it the week after when we're back in town. So thanks for watching.
Thanks, guys.
As always, I'm Jeff.
I'm Jason.
Later.
Peace.